Nerdyers, it's me. Just wanted to actually show you that you don't have to always be frustrated by natural hair. There are days, of course, where you just don't want to have to deal with your hair. That happens even with relaxed hair, straight hair, no matter what texture. So there are options, and there's nothing wrong with being natural and maybe trying a weave once in a while or a wig or whatever. Just do you. So I'm actually going to show you, I'm going to put on a wig for today. I wore my hair, I washed it, and then I put in bantu knots last night, and it's rainy and dreary outside, and I don't want to take them out. So, and sometimes you don't want to do that. Maybe you have an event that evening or something coming up, and you want your curls to really pop and be their freshest, so you don't want to take your twists out or whatnot quite at that moment. So a wig is a really good option. The wig that I'm going to be wearing is actually $20 number that I actually got up the street at just a little hair shop. It's a little Beverly Johnson half wig, so it's got the little comb in here that you're gonna pin it, you know, use to secure it in your hair. And I've done it with headbands so that I'm, you know, when I'm too lazy to do anything, which I'm gonna do today. And I've done it where I've actually, and you can see it in my natural hair journey video, where I've actually just blended the hair and made it look really natural as well. Just make sure, please don't be one of those people out there with one of those yakky wigs or whatnot that is super straight and looks a hot mess with your nappy roots. Let's just keep it real, folks.
We interrupt your regularly scheduled programming to bring you this public service announcement. While wigs and weaves can be a very good option, they can just as easily be bad, bad, bad. Notice the inconsistency between the roots and the rest of the hair. Notice the poorly applied lace fronts. And notice the rainbow of ridiculous colors. Please, fellow journeyers, choose your wigs and weaves wisely. You never want to be featured in this photo gallery. Only you can prevent this foolishness. We now return you to your regularly scheduled programming already in progress.
So this one is just that. It's very, very curly, and I do kind of fluff it out when I first got it because it was a lot kind of more defined than this, and I do want it to look natural. So just so you'll know, I don't like wearing wigs very long because my head tends to get sweaty, or I just don't like the feel of it. So I don't usually wear a wig cap very often, and I'm not going to today. So I'm literally just gonna shove this on my head. This is gonna take used to some getting used to being on YouTube and looking awful or putting a wig on my head. But I want to keep it real about, you know, what I do with my hair. So this is my wig, and I literally just pinned it in. Take the little combs that are part of the wig, I think you can see that there, and, you know, use them to hold it in however tight or not tight you want, and just make sure that you've got everything covered. Again, you don't want to be one of those folks out there who looks like they've got a $20 wig on their head. The fact that I do is one thing. I don't want you to know it. I actually used to buy expensive wigs, but nowadays I don't have the patience to wash. I've never had good luck with washing wigs and getting them to detangle, so I prefer to just spend the 20 bucks, wear it a time or two, throw it away, and get a different one. So I'm not going to spend a couple $100 or even $100 on a wig. This literally was 20 bucks. It was the last one they had, so I think I actually even got it for like $16 or $17. But, okay, so it's got the combs in the back. It's more like a little strap thing if that you like it even tighter or looser or whatever, or if you don't like the combs. I kind of prefer the combs. I don't know why. Even when I twist and braid my hair, I just like my head to feel secure for some reason. So this is my wig look. I'm going to actually put a headband on, because usually I would take out like maybe one or two of the bantu knots up front and then just kind of take some maybe Miss Jessie's or something that'll give you really that curl pop and just make sure that my curls kind of match these in texture and definition. But it's rainy, it's nasty outside, and I just don't feel like it. Okay guys, so this is it. I put my headband on up here and just fluffed it out a little bit. 2 minutes, and this is just a great look for days when it's raining, days where you don't want to take your twists out, or sometimes you just have to, you know, you want some variety. Sometimes you have that man in your life who he loves your natural hair, except when he's around his mama or around his boys. So sometimes we have to be flexible or whatever. So it's just a very easy way, easy look. And I also like, I mean, you can do straight wigs, straight weaves or whatever. I like the fact that because it is curly, it still kind of matches what my own hair is doing, my own texture and whatnot. And so for people who don't know me or whatnot, I've had many a person who didn't realize it was a wig when I, you know, blended and that sort of thing really well. I've worn it up, I've worn it down, I've done all kinds of things with it. And you can see those in the hair journey videos. But very easy breezy sort of look. And it allows me to get out the door really quick. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you guys can all find $20 wigs in the store near you. And I hope that you have a great day. Thanks. Peace.
I'm tipsy, trying to last. I wanna change her name to Mrs. Nice. There's nothing left to say, 'cause she rockin' as she like. She rockin' as she like. There's nothing I can say, she rockin' as she like. The first sight of morning.